Hello, it's Angus at the Bureau. You might have seen our Monday and Friday weather update videos, but I can do you one better. How about a midweek update? And for the next few days, fine weather for most places, but we're watching a cold front in the southeast that will bring a burst of wintry weather down to this part of the country. Now, for Wednesday, the key thing is this belt of high pressure, and high pressure brings settled weather, really exerting its influence almost everywhere. Fine conditions for most, not a lot of this stuff, not a lot of rain, just a few isolated showers and storms for interior WA, and some spot showers along the east coast for northern New South Wales and Queensland. And that leads us nicely into Thursday's forecast, where again it's going to be fine and dry. No sign of much wanted or needed rain across the likes of South Australia. In fact, the only spots that are going to get any wet weather at all really are the east coast of Queensland, just some spotty hit and miss showers, nothing significant. And at the end of the day, a front onto southern Tasmania, which we will talk about more shortly. But before we get to that, a quick look at Thursday's temperatures. And we do see pretty typical stuff actually for this time of year, high single digits or low double digits for all southern areas. And of course, the further north you go, the warmer it is, but we're still in the mid-20s right at the top of the country. For the high temperatures on Thursday, nothing too much jumps out across the east or the southeast. 22 Sydney, 18 Canberra, 18 Hobart, 19 Melbourne, 22 Adelaide, all pretty close to their averages. What does jump out though, 28 degrees in Perth. Now yesterday, 29.4 in Perth, that was a record for this time of year, and we've got 28 degrees in the forecast for the next several days. So we're looking at a run of unprecedented warmth there. Now to Friday, we'll watch this cold front across Tasmania in the morning, Victoria in the afternoon, just into the south of New South Wales to end the day. Outside of that, not a lot to point to on the map. Settled and sunny conditions again, bone dry across South Australia, Northern Territory, WA, and most of Queensland. One or two light showers again likely to clip the coastline. So we'll zoom in to the southeast for timing, and it's going to be really early in the morning, 1 a.m. 2 a.m. when this front goes through Hobart, bringing a line of showers and a possible round of hail down there. It's then Friday, about the middle of the day, where we'll see the cooler and showery conditions move into Victoria, and we might just finish off the week with a late shower in both Sydney and Canberra. Not a lot of rain with this front as it passes, perhaps 50 millimetres for Western Tas, but only 5 to 15 millimetres elsewhere. But without the rain, we could still see a little bit of snow. Snow potentially falling as low as 500 metres on Friday afternoon across Tasmania. That could be the lowest snow of the year so far. Not that much snow for mainland Australia, but a dusting above about 1,200 metres for the alpine areas of Victoria and New South Wales. Temperatures on Friday, no big changes here in the morning, but we'll start to see the cooler air spread across mainland and southern Australia on Friday afternoon. Just 14 degree maximum in Hobart, still really, really warm in the southwest, another 28 degree day for Perth. It's when we go forward that next day into the weekend, we see that cooler weather spread right across this area, temperatures falling into the teens and paving the way actually for a cool run of weather to end this week, through the weekend and into next week as well. But if you'd like more on those cooler conditions, find your local forecast at the Bureau website and app, or check back in on Friday when we'll have our regular weather update. Thanks very much for tuning in.